You're a voter next year.
Yes.
Yeah. Let's put that on the table. You've made it clear that you're one of the 13 FOMC members. You must be one of the dots that sees no moves, no rate cuts, no rate hikes, unless something happens in 2020. Mm-hmm. What has to happen?
There has to be a material change in the outlook, either for better or for worse. I've already got baked into my outlook. We're going to have weak manufacturing next year, sluggish global growth, pretty sluggish business investment, but with a strong consumer. There would have to be some material change from that outlook.
Which way are the risks tilt in your mind?
I think it's fairly balanced at the moment. And for a number of reasons. I'm hoping we'll get some stabilization in trade. I think the moves the Fed has made have also been helpful. And I'd say the risks, though, are balanced.
If you see the real risk tilting toward the upside and the possible need for a rate hike, would that be hard to do in an election year? Would you consider that ill-advised, something the Fed will try to avoid?
It will not be a factor in my thinking, in that I'm going to, as usual, divorce political considerations, political influences. I think we'll try to make the best decision we can in light of the circumstances, use our best judgment.
You know, you repeated this morning, as you have said for a while, you expect 2% growth next year.
Yeah.
That hasn't changed. 3.5% unemployment.
Yeah.
So it sounds to me like you don't really expect the passage of the phase one trade deal to have much impact on the economy, certainly not out of the gate.
Yeah, probably that's probably correct. I'd been hoping there would be some trade stabilization generally. This is part of that. That's not to say, and you've heard me say this before, I think the trade issues with China are going to go on for years, not months, but years. I think most businesses are adjusted to that. These issues of intellectual property, technology transfer, and the much deeper issues with China are going to be going on for a long time. And so phase one is better than not having phase one, but it doesn't mean there won't still be trade uncertainty.